A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Neuralink, probably together with the Boring Company, one of the more underrated companies by Elon Musk. However, if successful, Neuralink could be at least as disruptive as SpaceX or Tesla. But why? Why does Neuralink have such a huge disruptive potential?
Well, think about the applications for long-term spaceflight and for leisure activities on the future colonies on the Moon and on Mars. Wow, an interesting concept to discuss, so stay tuned.
When we started this YouTube channel, really in our first video, we talked about cyberpunk technology. And what could be more cyberpunk than neural interfaces? The idea to connect our brains with machines. Back then, about 2 years ago, almost nothing was known about Neuralink. Only in July 2019 did Elon officially reveal Neuralink in a quite impressive presentation. So then, what is Neuralink actually? Neuralink is a brain-computer interface, which holds the promise of communicating with machines. In the first Neuralink presentation, Elon and his team introduced the Neuralink N1 device, the first prototype brain-machine interface from the company. Elon explained that Neuralink works by attaching some very thin wires to parts of the brain with a high-precision surgery machine. Then you would attach a battery-powered device to the side of the ear, which would allow the brain-machine interface to work. It would be shut off if the device was removed. The electrical signals in the brain are picked up by the thin wiring in the brain and interpreted by the N1 chip. Thus, the thoughts can be identified using sophisticated algorithms in order to know what the brain is thinking and sending these signals to other devices, for example, to smartphones or PCs, which we then can completely control only using our thoughts. Of course, being still in the early stages, Neuralink was back then still quite far away from mainstream. The device still required some pretty invasive surgery, despite, of course, being performed by a high-precision robot. Still, it left us with a quite uneasy feeling when watching the presentation. This first-generation Neuralink prototype was clearly envisioned for medical patients.
Now, for medical use cases, such an invasive insertion might be justified, because the N1 would not only allow to control devices, but it would also go the other way. N1 could allow, for example, deaf people to hear again or blind people to see by actually sending electrical signals from the outside world into the brain. And as Morpheus perfectly explained to Neo in Matrix Part 1, what we define as reality is nothing else than electrical signals interpreted by the brain. However, we think the average consumer wouldn't have liked the idea to get long wires implanted into the brain. Enter the updated Neuralink prototype V0.9. The latest Neuralink prototype was revealed only 3 months ago in August 2020, and it is really a huge step up compared to the first prototype. This new device, called Link V0.9, is a lot smaller and doesn't require long wires inserted into the brain. What is even more interesting is it can be taken out again, meaning the whole process is completely reversible. So if one day you want to get a Neuralink implanted into your brain and at some point you decide you don't like it anymore, it can be completely removed without any traces. This was impressively demonstrated with pigs. We could see some pigs having the Neuralink implant. They were perfectly fine and healthy. And by the way, all this was done with approval and in cooperation with animal protection agencies in the US. So some of these pigs had the implant, while another one had the implant before. But it had been removed in order to show that the pig was perfectly fine and healthy. One pig that had the implant was demonstrated in more detail, where we saw the implant in action. The implant could read the brainwaves of the pig and exactly reconstruct where all the limbs were located at any given moment. This means people who have lost a limb could have robotic limbs, which they then could control using the link. The potential use cases for Neuralink are vast, but some of the things it could cure are, for example, these conditions here. Memory loss, hearing loss, blindness, paralysis, depression, insomnia, extreme pain, seizures, anxiety, addiction, strokes, or brain damage. So for medical applications, Neuralink will just be a boon for so many people suffering from one or more of these medical conditions. It's amazing. And if you want to support our YouTube channel and help us to continue talking about all kinds of disruptive technologies, then please check out our favorite online learning platform, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where millions of people come together to take the next step in their creative journey. With thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including programming, illustration, design, and so many more. We have been using it for quite a while now, and lately we've been trying out the Creative Toolkit, 6 techniques to spark original ideas. In this class, teacher, author, and comedian Esteban Guest breaks down the science of creativity and shares how the right systems and processes can create better ideas in order to help you achieve your goals in life. What makes Skillshare different from other online learning platforms is that there are class projects where you can practice your new skill, get feedback from the teacher, and exchange with the other students.
The best value for money would be the annual subscription at less than $10 a month. And the first 1,000 people using our special link can even have a free trial of the Skillshare premium membership. So be sure to use our special link. Join Skillshare today and start to learn anything you like, from home or anywhere you prefer. It will be a real lifesaver for hundreds of millions of people. However, we are of course more interested in the other applications of Neuralink, and we believe that there will be many more applications besides the obvious health benefits. First, it's important to remember that Neuralink can not only read, but also write. It can write information into your brain. Thus, you can learn new abilities with Neuralink much faster. You will even be able to train your brain with Neuralink in order to increase cognitive functions and reach a higher intelligence. And of course, famously, Elon often said that Neuralink should also help us to merge with a potential future AI superintelligence in order to make us an indispensable part of that AI. Thus, the AI superintelligence will not exterminate us, because we will be connected and part of it. For the AI, exterminating humanity would then be like cutting off its own arm. But there are even more interesting applications of Neuralink. For example, in spaceflight, we all know that a voyage to Mars with Starship will be a very long trip, an extremely long and lonely trip actually, with currently estimated travel time of at least 3 months best case, but quite likely as long as 6 months. Imagine being cramped inside a volume of only 1,000 cubic meters, together with at least 20, possibly even 30 people in such a small volume, for 6 months. The psychological implications are, in our opinion, not to be underestimated. In a NASA study from 2011, the minimum habitation volume per crew person for different voyage lengths was estimated based on different psychological factors. We can see that the function follows a logarithmic curve. So for a 180-day voyage to Mars, we would get a minimum space of 22 cubic meters per person. In the case of Starship, this would mean a maximum crew complement of 45. However, we would say that without any additional technology, even this number is quite high. And we believe that 30 is a more realistic number for the first Starship trips to Mars.
However, we have often heard Elon saying that 100 people should be transported to Mars per Starship. And this is where Neuralink will come in very handy. Why? Because imagine everyone having a Neuralink device implanted, which would allow them to couple for a few hours every day into the ship's holodeck simulation. Yes, every Starship would come equipped with a Neuralink dock, which would allow people to have sensory data of all senses transmitted from the ship's computer directly into their brains. Thus, they could load simulations of all kinds. When they have enough of being confined with their crewmates in that small volume, they could go, for example, for a walk in Central Park, New York. Or they could go for a swim at Montego Bay in Jamaica. Or go mountain biking in Arizona. There would be no limits to what people could do, because new applications could be written all the time. There would be an app store for hyper-realistic simulations. But now many people say, hey, we already have virtual reality. We have the HTC Vive, Oculus Rift and so on. Why should be Neuralink better than what we already have? Well, simple, because Neuralink would encompass all senses. It would feel like you would really be in a different place, not on a starship. With a regular VR headset, you only get the visual and auditory information. With Neuralink, it would also additionally encompass feeling, smelling, and even tasting. You could maybe even enjoy a virtual cocktail at the beach. So, psychologically speaking, this would make a huge difference to interplanetary travel. This would dramatically increase the psychological well-being on trips to and from Mars. And of course, later on, to further away destinations in the outer solar system. Maybe to the moons of Jupiter or Saturn with Starship 2.0.
We actually go even further and would say that without such holodeck simulations, many people would go insane and start going berserk. So Neuralink would be really helpful on long journeys. But on our future Moon and Mars settlements themselves, holodeck simulations could of course also be used as well. Now sure, for shorter duration stays on the Moon, Neuralink probably wouldn't be necessary, since the Moon is only 2 days away. So you could do short trips to the Moon with Starship, like with Apollo. But people traveling to Mars would have to really stay there for at least 2 years until the next return window to Earth would open.
And we can be very sure that the first Mars spaces won't be very comfortable. You won't have a Ritz-Carlton on Mars for probably quite some time. So these bases could also greatly benefit from a Neuralink hub connected to the base computer, which would allow to load many holodeck simulations. People could also play multiplayer holodeck games together. We think that Quake 7 will become a very popular multiplayer pastime activity where the whole family, big and small, will be joined and have a lot of fun virtually fragging people. Just kidding, but of course, playing games in a virtual world with the other inhabitants of the base could really become a very big thing. Because on Mars, you won't be able to do many of the things which on Earth we take for granted. No jogging outside. No feeling the wind in your hair. No anything outside without a spacesuit. And of course, the sun will also be noticeably weaker. And then the sky is red instead of blue. Except during sunset and sunrise, of course.
And during global dust storm event, the days would be very dark. And you would barely be able to see the sun at all for months and months in a row. During this time, some nice activities in the virtual Neuralink holodeck simulation would be probably very nice. And in case someone would really still develop a psychological disorder, the Neuralink will also help to overcome that disorder. Because there won't be many pharmaceutical production plants around, you know? So calming you down with the help of Neuralink might be really a good thing. So what do you think? What other possibilities could Neuralink offer us on our future settlements in space? Did we forget anything important? Tell us in the comment section.
And if you live long enough, you might even see Elon become president of Mars, an idea about which we talked in this video here.
So thanks for watching the JS Disruption Report. And I would say, on to the future.
To the ship's holodeck. I cannot speak English today.
Many people would go insane and start going berserk. Is it probably together with the Boring Company? No.